national clearance rates, and then we'll compare your numbers with Tom's numbers and see how Tom's doing these days.
Okay, well, look at the national clearance rate first. That was 65.7% for the week, which again has been in the 60s now for a while. That's an area I think that we've needed to become or get to make it viable for us. 64.4% was what it was last year, so not a lot of difference. But Sydney performed the best at 71.8% clearance rate, and that was followed by Melbourne at 66.1%. And Adelaide has been in the 60s for a while, so that's been coming in third, followed by Brisbane and Canberra. It depends on where you want to look. So those clearance rates are in what I think a good place right now.
And Tom, for the people that don't follow you on Facebook and don't get the normal Saturday run, how are you doing?
Well, so I'm in Sydney, and the number that Charles has come up with is 71 or 72%. I've got to tell you, you must take ginkgo biloba. That's what a great herb. It helps you remember everything. This guy's got the most amazing memory.
He's unbelievable, isn't he?
Well, you know, you've got to remember phone numbers, Tom, don't you, when you want to call people back?
Correct. So what I was going to say is that my clearance rate has been hovering between 90 and 95. The inner west is not, inner west of Sydney, is not indicative of the rest of Australia.
It's not, nowhere near.
So,
it's not indicative of Sydney.
Yeah.
Either. So that's the important thing. Tom is a senior top auctioneer. He's called upon to do auctions.
His mother told him he's unique, and you're saying the same thing.
He's called upon to do, well, very unique.
We're friends again now.
Okay, yeah, homes advertised for sale. So we've actually got 2 or 3 weeks, haven't we?
Up this week over last week, which is really interesting, 0.88%. And last week was only 0.38% increase over the week before. So it's actually climbed just a little bit, which is very unusual this time of the year. It usually does slow down. Most of the New Zealand market also, that was up, except for you've got areas like Manawatu and Whanganui, which were a little bit lower than normal. But overall, the listing numbers are starting to climb. And I'm really quite happy about that too.
And how are we going with the rents at the moment?
Now, I'm going to start a new chart next year. I'm going to start it from zero and see how the movement is up or down over the 12 months. But for the chart that we've been keeping for 24 months now, Sydney's sitting at 12.84%, Melbourne at 8.66%, and Perth's been the best performer at 19.59%. And that's given us an average this week of 13.69%.
Wonderful. And very quickly, just the vacancy rate.
0.01% Sydney, 3.66% Melbourne, and Perth, all 7.27%, taking the average up to 4.31%. That's the danger area.
Wonderful. Charles Darby from Century 21, Tom Pannis from News Limited, my two favourite guests. Good to see you guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us on the show as well. Until next week, I'm Chris Gray. Good night.
The information featured in this program is general.